We'll now look at another object. It's on a 45 degree plank and accelerating down the plank at a rate of 3.7 meters per second squared. What is the coefficient of kinetic friction between the block and the plank? Okay, so it's on a 45 degree plank. So I'm going to draw it at an angle. And if the angle of the plank is 45 degrees, that means it's going to accelerate down the ramp. We know what the acceleration is. It says it's 3.7 meters per second squared. So I'm going to use this as the x direction and this is the y direction. I know that W goes this way. They don't tell us the mass of the plank. So I'm going to have to take that mass M, which I don't know, and multiply it by 9.81. And when I multiply 9.81 times the mass, I just get 9.81 M. That's M as an unknown mass, not M as in meters. I know that I'm going to have to break W into components. I'm going to need WY and WX, and I know that this angle up here is the angle of the ramp from the horizontal. And so I can find those two components. I multiply 9.81 M times the cos of 45, and I get 6.937 M. And if I do it times the sine of 45, I get the same thing. Now the normal force is in the y direction, in the perpendicular to the platform, the plank. It's perpendicular to the plank. It's going to be this way. And let's see, let's just finish off with the last force, which is friction, because friction is going to mean making it harder to accelerate down the ramp. Friction is going to be opposite the motion, opposite the way it's going. Okay, in the y direction, I have this and this. Those are my two forces in the y direction. I don't see anything else in the y direction, so they must balance because the acceleration is in the x direction. There's no acceleration in the y direction, so this has to be 6.937 newtons as well. And Fk equals mu k times n. Oh man, they didn't tell me what... they didn't tell me what mu k is. I suppose I could go ahead and multiply it times this. I made a mistake up here. Whoops. That should be an M. M as in times the mass, not newtons. We don't know how many newtons it is. It's 6.937 times the mass. That's how many newtons it is. Okay. Let's just go ahead and use Fnet equals MA. I'm going ahead because I know what the acceleration is, so I'm thinking the fact that I don't know exactly what Fk is maybe isn't going to be a problem. We can leave it as an unknown. If we look in the x direction, we have Wx in the same direction as x, and we have Fk going the other way. Those are the only things I see in the x direction. So let's do in the direction of x is Wx, and going against it is Fk. That's equal to Ma. Wx is 6.937 m, and Fk, we don't know what that is, equals m, we don't know what m is, times 3.7. Oh, wait a minute, I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to put Fk on this side, add Fk to both sides. If I look at that m times 3.7, that's 3.7 m. So what I'm going to do is subtract 3.7 m from both sides, so it's going to get subtracted from that thing. And I end up with 3.237 m. Okay, now remember Fk equals mu k times n. And we know what Fk is now, sort of. It's 3.237 m equals mu k times n. And we know the normal force is 6.937 m. You can see that there's m's on both sides of the equation. So I'm going to divide both sides by m, and there's no m anymore. Then I'm going to divide both sides by 6.937 to get rid of the 6.937 in front of that. And what I get is 0.467, which is not what I have here. So this must have been a mistake when I did it, because I've double-checked it now. And I'm getting 0.467 instead of the answer I got when I made the book. Notice there's no units on that. Again, mu k is a ratio. It's not a quantity. It tells you how big the friction force is compared to the normal force. So it's not in newtons, it's just telling you that in this case, it's just a little bit less than half of the normal force. Here we have a 300 gram block on a 20 degree ramp. It's attached by a string and pulley to a hanging mass. We want the 300 gram block to accelerate up the ramp at 1 meter per second squared. So we want it to accelerate this way. Hey, once again, we're given the acceleration. Okay, let's draw a free body diagram. We'll start with that block, that 300 gram block. It looks like this. And this is 0.3 kilograms. And W is pulling down straight on it with a force of the mass, 0.3 times G, which is 9.81. So that's 2.943. I know that it's going to accelerate up the ramp at 1 meter per second squared. So I'm going to draw A equals 1.0 meter per second squared. I can see a string pulling it, so there's T here. I know that friction is going to make it harder to go up. Friction is going to resist the motion. If it's moving up the ramp, then friction is the other way. And we have a normal force like this. Okay. Yeah, we're going to use one of those angled reference frames because that's what we do. X is going to be this way and Y is going to be this way. So you notice I've drawn X to be in the direction of the acceleration and Y is in this direction, which where there is no acceleration. Three of these forces line up with the reference frame, so that's great. They don't have to be broken into components. But one of them is partially in the X and partially in the Y direction. So we're going to break that into components. I'm going to draw the Y direction first and the X direction second. This angle here, we said, is going to be the same as the angle of the ramp. This is going to be WY. And this is going to be WX. We'll do 2.943 times the cos of 20 degrees. And that's 2.766 newtons. And 2.943 times the sine of 20 degrees is 1.007 newtons. Okay. There's no acceleration in the y direction. So if I look in the y direction, I've got N and WY. There's no acceleration, so those two have to balance. So this is going to be 2.766 newtons. And FK, let's just do a little calculation of FK over here. I think I have the information necessary to calculate this. Yes, they tell me mu K is 0.13, and the normal force is 2.766. I multiply that all out, and I get 0.360. I think I'm going to go ahead with F net equals MA because I have lots of information here. Let's see, what do we have in the X direction? In the direction of the acceleration, I have T. In the X direction, I have T, and WX and FK are both in the negative X direction. So T minus WX minus FK equals MA. T minus 1.007 minus 0.36 equals 0.3. Oh, and we know what A is. A is 1. So we can actually work all that out. 0.3 times 1 plus 0.36 plus 1.007 tells us that T equals 1.667 newtons. The question said, what mass would that need to cause the 300 gram block to accelerate? So, okay, so there's this hanging mass over here, which we haven't even drawn a free body diagram of because we were able to do so much with the first one. But now we have to look at what's going on over there. And they don't tell us what the mass is. So we don't know what that mass is. We know that there is a force pulling up in the string, and we just figured out that that tension was 1.667 newtons. And we know, okay, so if this is accelerating upwards, then this has to accelerate downwards this way. So we know that there's going to be an acceleration in this way of 1.0 meters per second squared. So downwards is going to be our positive direction. And this is W. Now, I could just leave W as it is, but it's easy enough to say W equals mg, and it's going to make it much easier a little further on. I can already see if we just put 9.81m, because what we don't know is m. So if we have m written somewhere else, that's okay. It's just one unknown. We can use it in two places in the equation, and that's going to be fine. So F net equals ma. F net is all the direction forces in the direction of the acceleration, which is w, minus all the forces going against the acceleration, which is t. So F net is going to be 9.81m minus 1.667. Well, let's just write that in symbols first. It's going to be the w minus the t is going to be equal to ma. 9.81m minus 1.667 equals m times 1. Oh, okay, so wait a minute. I have like terms here again. This m and this m are like terms. I think I had that in previous question. I'm going to subtract 1m from both sides, so I get 8.81m equals, and I'll put that constant on the other side. Now all I need to do is divide by 8.81 on both sides, and I find that m equals 0.189 kilograms. Whoa, I forgot the 1. 0.189 kilograms. And 0.189 kilograms is 189 grams.